The most important sanctuary representing the Syriacs in Mardin is Deir Zafaran Monastery. Situated on a small hill 5 kilometers from the city, it takes its name from the saffron flowers and most certainly deserves to be called the Pearl of Mardin with its magnificent and fascinating appearance. The Deir Zafaran Monastery, built at a distance of 4 to 5 kilometers from the province of Mardin, continues to be an important center for Syriac Christians and to welcome guests with its surreal atmosphere. Constructed on one of the first sanctuaries ever built in Mesopotamia, the monastery has been in use as a place of worship for 16,000 years. The Deir Zafaran Monastery resembles a medieval building erected in the middle of a steppe. Priests and seminarians living in it lead a life that has remained unchanged for hundreds of years. The stone walls of the monastery that were once saffron-colored have now changed color because of all the dust and soil that have accumulated on them over the centuries. The color of saffron derives its name from the saffron flowers that used to bloom on these mountains centuries ago. That is probably why saffron flowers were used in the plaster of the Deir Zafaran during its construction, so that the walls of the monastery would acquire this color. What about the story of Deir Zafaran? It is said that about 16,000 years ago, people who worshipped the sun sought a place where they could set up a temple. They wanted to build a temple before which the whole plain of Mesopotamia would extend and which would disappear among the mountains. They therefore built their temple at a distance of 4 kilometers from Mardin. The first owners of Deir Zafaran were therefore sun worshippers. At that time, Deir Zafaran was not such a big structure. It was constructed as a smallish underground temple. Later, it became one of the first churches of the Christian world in Anatolia. Today, the monastery still carries the marks of history and hosts 36 tombs belonging to Syriac metropolitan bishops and patriarchs. And now it is still used today as a temple and school by the Syriacs. As to the details, the most striking feature of the building is its geometrical roof made up of 13 stone rows. These stone rows are knitted to each other without any mortar. The throne from which the priests conduct the rituals has been located for more than 100 years at this monastery, which is famous for its domes, vaulted columns and wooden handmade decorations. A crown surrounded by dolphin figures welcomes you at the entrance door. And how should you come to this place? The monastery hosts many guests from Turkey and the world. Transportation to the monastery can be made by small buses or taxi rented in the city center. Syriac tourist guides to accompany you in the monastery and some informative documents on Deir Zafaran and the Syriacs are available at the main entrance. The monastery is open for visitors between 9 to 11 a.m. and 2 to 5 p.m. during the summer term. Since the monastery is still in use, speaking in loud voice, smoking, cell phones, eating and visiting the monastery without a guide are not allowed. So, if one day you feel that you wish to spend a day away from the present, in the distant past, the Deir Zafaran Monastery will lovingly welcome you.